Oil prices surged Monday after Saudi Arabia and other OPEC Plus producers announced a surprise output cut of over 1 million barrels per day starting May. The price of Brent crude oil was trading above $84 a barrel in Asia after jumping by more than $4 or 5%, while U.S. crude futures soared 5% to $79 a barrel. Saudi Arabia, the world's leading oil exporter, said the additional reduction is precautionary and is aimed at achieving stability in the global oil market. The Biden administration called the move unwise, but an oil analyst told Reuters OPEC's decision was made with caution, a clear sign that the group won't be deterred by Western interference.
This primary role of OPEC is to balance supply and demand, really on supply side micromanagement. They want to make sure they don't flood the market with oil, that they deliver the marginal barrel, and that they're able to balance the two, both supply and demand, to achieve a targeted price. And I think, in my view, I think that targeted price is $80 a barrel. But in this case, you know, the OPEC Plus group has taken a look at, they're predicting demand to increase by 2 million barrels a day in 2023.
Japan's business sentiment fell to a two-year low in the first quarter as slowing global growth dampened the outlook for the export-reliant economy. The Bank of Japan's Sankan survey for March 2023 showed manufacturers' sentiment reflected a fifth straight quarter of deterioration, with the headline index falling to plus 1 in March from plus 7 in December. Meanwhile, the survey reported recovery in the service sector mood thanks to relaxed border controls and COVID restrictions. Taiwan's President Tsai Ing-wen wraps up her three-day visit to Guatemala by offering more cooperation with the Central American country's government. Tsai says the two allies would continue to show solidarity and deepen their ties. This development comes about a week after Guatemala's neighbor Honduras said it now recognizes Taipei as part of China, severing its eight-decade-old alliance with the island nation. China and Taiwan have tussled for influence in Latin America since the end of the Chinese Civil War in 1949, with Beijing considering Taiwan part of Chinese territory, a claim that is strongly rejected by Taiwan. The head of Russia's Wagner mercenary group, Yevgeny Prigozhin, claims his forces have raised the Russian flag over the administration building of the town of Bakhmut in Ukraine. In a video message posted on the Telegram messaging app, Prigozhin said from a legal point of view, Bakhmut has been taken. But Prigozhin admitted that the Ukrainian military is concentrated in the western parts of Bakhmut. Ukraine dismissed the video as a stunt and insisted its army still holds Bakhmut, an eastern city which Russia has spent months trying to capture. In the U.S. now, the death toll from the series of powerful storms that ravaged parts of the South and the Midwest rises to 32. The storm spawned more than 50 tornadoes in at least seven states, wrecking homes, buildings, trees, and vehicles. Now, this catastrophe comes just a week after another severe storm and tornado pummeled the southeast, killing at least 26 individuals and damaged much of Rolling Fork, Mississippi. Aid workers boost relief efforts in Arkansas, one of the Midwestern states hit hardest by the destructive weekend tornadoes. Nonprofit resource Wolf Street Foundation hosted its venue for volunteers to cook and package ready-to-eat breakfasts, lunches, and dinners. The meals are to be distributed to storm-stricken communities.
We started coordinating as the storms were still rolling in because we knew that there would be a need. So working with other agencies like the Salvation Army, like Goodwill, with the city and other emergency management groups to get food and resources out where they need to go.